In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use SpiroFit to create this abstract art in 8 minutes. Let's press Shift, A, to create a teapot. If you don't see that in the menu, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. Let's press Shift, A, to create a SpiroFit. If you don't see that in the menu, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. SpiroFit creates a knot that wraps around any meshes like this. If I have a UV sphere and add the SpiroFit, I'll have an interesting curve that looks like this. Let's remove all the meshes and the curves, and create a plane. Tab, to go to edit mode. Right click and S, to subdivide like this. R, X, and 90, to rotate the mesh 90 degrees on the X axis. Let's remove 3 faces like this. In order to just remove the faces like I did, we must type 3, to face select before selecting the faces. Let's add the screw modifier. Please use any settings. The idea is to wrap a curve to an interesting mesh by using the SpiroFit. There is our interesting curve. We must use the SpiroFit's properties window at the bottom, and it can only be accessed right after we create a new SpiroFit. If we click away or select something else, the properties window will be gone forever. Let's make some changes to the settings, and turn this curve into a base abstract art mesh. It would be extremely difficult to make this shape manually. This is why SpiroFit is an amazing tool to use. Please feel free to make changes to the settings any way you like. All we need is a best-looking end result. Let's create a ground plane and scale it. I'll convert the curve to mesh. For the material, I'll lower the roughness and increase the transmission to turn it into a glass. I'll also add color ramp and gradient texture nodes as usual. Please increase the camera's clip setting like this. I'll use the sky texture. Let's create a shiny metallic material for the ground. Let's turn off Use Nodes under Compositing. I'll also use 32 samples to render. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.